direction to look. This is a really typical one. The that huge basin with the rock in the middle of it, the round rock, that is the first phase of making olive oil. That is crushing the olives, and that was usually done with a donkey or with men. Usually it would be an animal that would be dragging that rock around and around until all the olives were crushed. Then they were put into these woven straw sort of filter baskets, and they were stacked. And then this column right here had a large wooden beam that extended with weights on it, and then the baskets were stacked, and then that beam would come down on the baskets and press the baskets, and then the oil would go out into the basin. And the first press, of course, was the best. That's the extra virgin olive oil, and that was used for ritual purposes. It was tithed to the temple in Jerusalem for the lamp, the lampstand, the golden lampstand, and also for anointing oil, and all purposes used by the priest. The second press, that they would press, and then they would add more weight. After they'd get the oil from the first press, then they'd add more weights, and then that would come the second press, which would be for cooking and eating. And then afterwards, after they got that oil out, then they would add more weights, and then they'd have a third press, and the third press was usually used for the lighting of lamps in the houses, olive oil lamps. That's how they lit their houses at night, and even in the daytime, because not many houses had good windows. And then finally you had a mash, which could be used as fuel to light fires. So you had basically three presses of oil, and then the leftover
mash.
Gat shmanim means the press. A gat is a press. Shmanim is oil. Now sometimes a press could be used for both pressing out of grapes for making grape juice into wine, or it could be used for the oil. Now, generally speaking, the grape harvest is earlier than the olive harvest, so you can ostensibly use the same press for the two products.